Hi, it's Ursula from ursula-smith.com, and I did an earlier video using a two-part silicone mold making material to make molds for resin. So I've been on a huge resin kick lately, and I showed you how to use an AccuCut machine or die cuts, actually, from whatever machine you happen to have. This time I'm using those same materials, and I'm using, this actually happens to be a custom die cut that I made, but it's big, as you can see. You know, it's a big die cut, even a little large for me to wear as a pendant, so I'm going to use this with shrink plastic to make a mold. So here comes the idea. Hope you enjoy it, and thanks for joining me. Okay, hopefully third time's the charm. I've done this several times already. So I'm going to show you how I mix the two-part compound. I take two equal size pieces of the one of the purple, one of the white, and then I just mush it together. And it will start to marble, and I'm basically going to keep working it until it becomes a solid color, like a lighter shade of purple, and all the marbling is gone. So I will go off camera and do that, and I will be back. Okay, so now I have the silicone compound all mixed together. I'm just going to roll it into a ball. And then I'm going to take those acrylic blocks that I mentioned. They actually still have the paper on them. I should probably remove it. But I'm going to make a sandwich in between two pieces. And I'm just going to smush them together. And I'm going to go kind of turn it all the way around and just make sure that it's as even and flat as I can possibly make it. And then I'll remove one side and just kind of check it. And like I said, just try and make sure that it's as flat and even as possible. And then I'm ready to embed the shape. So now, in this case, I'm using a piece of shrink plastic, so it's a die cut that I cut and shrunk. It's a little wonky, but it's not bad. I already did the boot die cut, which is sitting here curing. And so I'm just going to take the piece, lay it on top of the shrink plastic, and then I'm going to take my acrylic block and press again. You can use credit cards. This is a little bit stiffer than a credit card, but credit cards work. The flat side of them anyway, gift cards probably, or swipe cards that, you know, are pretty flat work great. And then I'm going to remove the top, try not to gouge, and then I'm just going to go around and just make sure that the edges up against the die cut are fairly smooth and even all the way around. And then I will set it aside to cure. And I will be back. And I'm back. So I just wanted to show you, now that the silicone is cured, it's pretty stiff, but still flexible enough that I can pop out the shrink plastic. And now I have a mold. And in a much smaller version than the original boot. So it's perfect to add resin, or you can use it with polymer clay or air dry clay. Sky's the limit. So I hope you like that idea. Why don't you try it yourself? Thanks for joining me. See you next time.
So since I screwed up the first couple of videos, I actually ended up with a number of molds made from the shrink plastic. So these are actually big die cuts that I designed for scrapbooking. This one's a little wonky. I kind of smushed it a little bit when I was doing the shrink plastic, but shrunk it down, so could make a cool little finding or something. And then the same thing, this little frame, or it was a big frame, for again for scrapbooking, and now made small by the magic of shrink plastic. And again, of course, that goes along with my cowboy boot. So again, thanks for joining me. See you next time.